we are going to work on face detection. So now what I am going to do is, I want you all to switch on your picture box, okay? And like a fresh file, we are going to work on face detection, we are going to make face filters. So have you ever used face filters?
Yes.
Where? Oh, in picture box, that's great. Snapchat, okay. So we are now going to make our own face filter and understand the face detection activity. So please switch on your PictoBlocks with a fresh file. So I can see like a little creeps on some faces. So the first thing what I would request is to go to extensions, add a face detection and switch on the camera. Okay. You can drag the first block, okay, and check your faces. You will be very refreshed. Okay, that's great. Okay, so now coming back to part, what is face detection? So have you heard of face detection and face recognition? Do you think these two are different, the different concepts? Do you think face detection and face recognition are same or different? Okay, let's again have a poll, and this time I'm really counting, and if you want, I will note it down. Okay, so how many of you think face recognition and face detection is same? Yes, how many of you say yes, that face detection and face recognition is same? How many of you say yes? Yeah, half kya hota, half yes. Full yes, full no. Only one? Okay, others think face recognition and face detection is different. How many of you think face detection and face recognition is different? Okay, that's great. So now I'll tell you how exactly both of them are different. So first understand the concept that face detection means detecting the human faces, okay? The face recognition means specifically detecting the human face. Like in your phone, if I say it's face recognition, right? That is going to recognize only your face. But in case if you say, no, I don't want face recognition, I want face detection. So what will happen? It is going to open with everyone's face, means every human can open it. But face recognition comes up with a little more uniqueness, that it only recognizes the specific face which are stored. Like if I stored my face, I'll give you a better example. Let's think we have a camera here, okay? And it is able to detect that how many people are sitting in this classroom using the face detection. That is a face detection. But if in case this camera gives me an idea, okay, so this is Mr. Ayush, this is my friend Sukhan, okay, and it is also able to detect this is my friend. Okay, so this is face recognition because it is able to detect with my face landmarks, okay. Now we'll understand how exactly it works. So if you see, when I came to this classroom, how did you find, like, whether means Ayush is a human or a robot? Huh? I have human skin, okay. But now you might have heard of Sophia. How many of you know about Sophia or Asha robot? Okay, so these are the human intelligent, artificially intelligent robot. And Sophia is one of the robots who has got the citizenship as well. Okay? So they also have. So how you were able to judge, like, yeah, this person is not a robot. This is some human. Because some of you might have seen me for the first time, right? Agree? You might have not seen me before this. ओके बट दिस इतना इमोशन तो रोबोट भी देता है, देता है, कोई इशू नहीं. ओके सो बिकॉज यू नो विथ योर नॉलेज अगेन फ्रॉम द लाइक योर चाइल्डहुड यू हैव सीन व्हाट आर रोबोट्स व्हाट आर ह्यूमंस राइट. So you saw me like talking to people, you saw me walking, you saw me like working on the computers, you saw me thinking, you saw me talking. So with these understanding you were able to decide, yeah, this is not a robot, this is a human. Right? Apart from it, we also see the faces, right? When we see a face, generally we can see when we are able to see two eyes. We are able to see one nose, a face structure with two ears. We are able to see, we are able to say, yeah, this is human. In a one go, we can see, right? So, even sometimes happens like we are not able to, we are able to say, oh, this is a human, but that is a robot. Sometimes these smart robots are already in the market. So, how exactly it works is when machine see a human. Okay, and it works on a human face detection. It first what it does is it comes up with a landmark. Landmarks are nothing but the face points. So it will arrange some points on your face. Okay, and every point would be having some x coordinate and y coordinate. Do we all agree? As that we have already worked on picto blocks. So what happens there is when it is able to make a pattern, with that pattern, as I said, it takes that all knowledge, goes back to the brain of the machine, checks the pattern, that means like it checks that whether this pattern looks like a human or not. When it is able to match that pattern with already knowledge what it has, it says this is a human, right? Sometimes if you even see machines like after you can say some machines are not so smart, but still if you see like in a camera, normal camera, if you even bring a photo of a person, it would be able to detect the face, right? But that is not a face detection very clearly, right? Because you are showing a digital image there. You cannot say like in photo if you are showing it is able to detect, because somewhere it's not a you can say a real face. Or even if I say mannequins, have you seen mannequins? Do you know mannequins? No? How many of you don't know? How many of you know? Okay. So mannequin basically, shop ke bahar basically if you see usme kapde latke rehte hai, right? और लोगों ने बहुत बड़े बड़े स्टैचूज देख रखे राइट, स्टैचूज जैसे राइट, वाइट कलर, ब्लैक कलर, राइट. तो वो मैनिक्विंस है, तो वो भी हमारे जैसे दिखते हैं, है ना. तो बट क्या आपको लगता है मशीन को मतलब मैं कोई ऐसा भी बना लूँ कि फेस डिटेक्शन से मैं उसका लॉक लगा दूँ, कोई खोल ही नहीं पाएगा कभी दोबारा, राइट. बट इट इज नॉट एबल टू, इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू डिटेक्ट दैट. The reason behind it is, as I said, it works on an algorithm which comes up with the coordinate system of every particular information on your face and then matches with the information. Okay? So this is how face detection works. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to make an activity of face filter. So have you made, before face filter, have you made an activity of face expression detection? Have you worked with that? Okay, no problem, we will directly work with the face filter, just give me a second. Okay, so for face filter, what is the first important thing? Great. Yeah. Actually, this is like called as intelligence actually. So yeah, others? Camera is required. Yeah, face is something. Do we all agree with this? For face filter, the sabse important thing by face hona chahiye, right? Okay. So now, how we can bring the face, dear students? Dear students, second painting. कोई बंद कर दो. Listen to me. Okay, we'll paint also. Don't worry. So now coming back, कि for the face detection, what do we need to have? First thing is the face filter is face. But how we can come up with the face in the picto blocks? Okay, one person knows. How many of you know how we can bring face in the picto blocks? Okay, so that's great. I'll now explain you because this is very important.
What does this block do?
bounding ball. So, like to relate it with your example is like if, as I said, when you use your camera, phone camera, so what happens there is there comes a bounding box, right? So to bring that bounding box actually into the picto block, we use this block. So this is a very important block, okay? Because this will basically clear your idea of artificial intelligence. Okay? So what do you think what it is? Set the direction threshold. Sorry, detection threshold. First tell me, do you know the meaning of threshold? Have you ever heard of threshold word? You have heard of it? What is threshold? There. Anyone else? Just forget this. Tell me, have you heard of threshold word? No? Are you yes? No? How many yes? One, two, three. How many no? Okay. Now I'll tell you what is threshold. So, okay. So what happens is there is a minimum base value you can consider, okay, after which certain thing happens. Like if I say that is kerosene, right? Have you heard of kerosene?
Yes.
Kerosene oil. And do you know petrol, right? So do you think if I put a fire with a one matchstick on petrol, will I be able to put fire on kerosene as well with one matchstick? No, I think, because both of them have different burning points, right? Matlab, again I should say ki petrol, when we talk about we heat the petrol to 100 degrees, just assume assumptions, right? So if I give 100 degrees Celsius to petrol, it will start burning, okay? But for kerosene it's not 100, right? For kerosene it's little higher because it's not such volatile. Do we agree? Okay, I'll take different example. So let's assume water. Water boils faster or milk boils faster? Water boils faster. So there would be some value for water, that at this particular point water will start boiling. Is that value same for milk? No. Both of them have different threshold values. After this particular point only, they will start boiling. So have you got an idea? Basically, it's a baseline, you can say. Ye itna threshold hoga, tabhi wo iske upar work karna shuru karega. Till that time, you are not going to give a certain amount of heat to cross the threshold value of the water. It will not start boiling. Do you all agree? Now, how can we relate it to the artificial intelligence? What is this? Now, what is this? Okay, and if I hide it all, and I keep it something like this, and if you don't know, will you be able to detect it? What is it? You would be able to, yes, he would be, he is very near to me. But on the last, if I say what is it in my hand, what is it in my hand, you can say, right? Right? Fine. Because he is able to see this, right? So he is able to get that threshold value for detection. That if I say that 10% is a threshold for detection, right? So he was able to see the 10% of the pen. But if I talk to the last teacher or the last student sitting, were they able to see the 10%? No. Right? So they were not able to cross that threshold. So that is why they were not able to make the decision. Coming, same to example what I told. In the night, what happens is when you see two wheelers coming from the road, and you see when they are coming up from very long distance, first you think that is a four-wheeler, right? The next, when they come in very close to you, at that time you are able to detect, right? Oh, this was not a four-wheeler, this was two-wheeler. Because your brain has a certain threshold value to detect certain things. Till the time, your mind would not be approximately, we can say, 50% sure about it. You cannot take a decision. So your mind was waiting till it confirmed that 50%, now 50% are confirmed, this is two-wheelers, not a four-wheeler. When it happened, when it came very near to you, right? So threshold is basically a bare minimum value that has to be crossed, then only your mind or the machine would be able to give you the answer or the detection. Have you all understood? नहीं आए तो बताओ और भी ऑप्शन है. क्लियर है? ओके, तो ये हो गया. नाउ व्हाट डू यू थिंक ऑफ दिस ब्लॉक? ओके गुड. नाउ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, बट इट डजंट मीन दैट वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू गिव द इंस्ट्रक्शंस टू द मशीन. We are going to give the instructions to the machine, but we are not going to, modulate their decisions. But instruction has to be given. Machines are non-living things, right? So this is basically an instruction which is given to the machine after when you switch on your camera and says, now it's your time, just analyze whatever you see in the camera. Okay? Understood? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, so here if you see, I've taken two blocks. The first block says, what is it written? Get hash faces. So basically hash is generally used when you want to use a number. So get the number of faces. So with the block it is very clear what it is going to store. How many faces are there? Do we all agree? Okay. So now the second block is get the x position of the face. Basically it will find the x coordinate of your face, the y coordinate, the width and the height of your face on the screen. Okay? Do we all agree? Okay. So now we have understood almost all the blocks. There are more blocks which of course you can learn by yourself, but these are the basic ones which I wanted you to understand so that you are clear with the foundation and the basics. Okay? So now we are going to make a face filter application. So we are going to do that in the same way how exactly we work with the people in the maze. So we will first make it by talking and then we will come to the coding part. So what do you want to happen when you switch on the camera? Okay, so basically you want that it should detect first thing that whether there is a human or not, right? First thing, do we all agree? Once it is confirmed, yeah, this is a human, then a face filter should come up. The face filter can be different or a single as well. So first we would be coding it for one and then we would be coding it for multiple face filters. But do you want to see the landmarks on your face? Like I just showed it to you on the presentation. So there was a girl and there was landmark. So would you like to see that landmark on your own face?
Yes.
Okay. So right now I'm not programming that. But I'll directly open. You can also open from examples. So this is an example face landmark. all of you are able to get this program. Now press the green flag and keep your face in front of it. Keep try to keep only one face at a time.
Others, do you want to give a try?
that what exactly this block is doing, this red and this green. Okay, yeah.
If red block is greater than 0, then if condition will true.
Totally correct. So basically, as discussed, once I have given an instruction to the machine to analyze the image, the next step is it is going to inform, it is going to store the information of how many faces it has detected, right? So that information would be stored in this block, right? And we are comparing it to 0. Can we have, can we have any faces smaller than 0? Is there any possibility? Right. There is no possibility, right? It can be 0. It can be with 0 means there is no face in front of the camera. While greater than 0 means, of course, there are number of faces. But it cannot be in minus, right? Now, the next is, don't go on so much depth because I would be explaining, we would be making certain codes like this. I want you to get an idea of this, okay? So basically what we have done is we have created a variable landmark, okay? So we are placing this, okay? We are placing this small ball in X position and the Y position of every landmark detected. I am getting my point. Like, agar main wo machine hoon pictoblocks ke andar aur mujhe bola gaya ki ye ek face hai, inke aap detect karo and inke landmarks batao. So what I did, I first understood, okay? Then I started taking a small balls and started placing on the landmarks in position which I have understood. So in this case, what machine does or a pictoblock did is, it took this sprite and kept on all the information taken up, okay, and stored in the, pictoblocks from the camera. Do we all agree? Machine ko jitna samajh aaya, unhone us hisab se wahan pe laga diya. Sari choti choti balls. Cloning kya hoti hai, don't get into all this. I'll explain you this later. Okay, so now coming to the face filter application. You can open a new file. This was actually why I wanted to see, is like I saw again like some of you were sleeping, so I thought they both could catch a name. Okay, so open a new file. And now we are going to make a program logically, okay? Logically program banayenge na ki yaad karke. So, a very logically face filter application mein kaun sa sprite lagega? You can delete this sprite and add a face filter sprite here. Delete this sprite and add a face filter sprite. Are we all ready with this? what do you want to do to turn on the camera? You will bring down the block, which is yes, turn on the video. Yeah, you can just bring that block. After that, the next is you will be using a forever. The reason behind forever is because you might be moving your face, right? So you would be, your program will look good, like if you are moving as well as your face will tell is moving, right? So use forever and give instruction of analyze. About bonding box, I would like to tell you a very important point. This becomes little confusion for many times. In picture blocks, by default only you have a bounding box. Generally, that particular block is used when you want to hide the bounding box. Sometimes what you are making is, you are making some other programs that you might have seen, drowsiness detection and all, right? So in those cases, we don't need the bounding box. So basically, by default, it is going to come up with a bounding box. We use that particular block as a when we want to switch off the bounding box, okay? So you don't always need to use that block to bring up. If you want to hide that, then you can use that block, okay? Right? So now the thing is, I like to, we can have two programs at a time that will give more interesting program out here. So we are going to add one more thing is face expression detection. So do you know what is face expression detection? Okay. Others, do we know what is face expression detection? Do we know what are different face expressions we have? Happy, sad, angry. Emotional is sad. Yes, sad. Nervous, disgusted, excited, surprised, right? So if I come up like, what is this expression? Happy. Expression is happy, right? And if I say, surprise and angry, right? So these are the different expressions. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to make something here. My machine is going to tell me what expression is in on my face, okay? So just we are going to add a very simple block. Okay. And now you can just click by adding these blocks on the script and see whether it is able to detect our expressions or not. Are you able to get the expressions?
Yes, sir.
Is it interesting? Do you think your machines are smart now?
No.
No? Okay. Yeah. Okay, so now we are going to just work this fourth block. Can anyone tell me what is the first block which I have right now? My pointer is going to give me an output. The x coordinates of the face. Do we all agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Now, in that particular, that is same. We are setting up the x and y for the right, and both we are moving. That is both y for the condition. So, now here, if you see, I have an x position of phase 1, right? I can duplicate this block. Can I duplicate this block?
Yes.
Right click, duplicate. And I'll put it one here, and in y, I have to change it to y. Very important, okay? I'll duplicate it one more time. And what I'm doing here is, I'm setting it to the size. Okay, so basically, I can keep it width or a height. But for a better result, I'm going to use the width. And it, as you know, at last I have to use when green flag is clicked. Now let's check whether it works or not. Is it working?
Yes.
So for this, this is very basic one, okay? We can also make it tilt as well, okay? We can also work with the tilt. So keep your face straight. You would be able to do it. Can anyone tell me why my sprite has gone very small right now? Because it's not detecting the face. Since it is not detecting the face, so it would be 0% across, right? So it is what? It is very small. So are you able to move your sprite to your eyes? Even if you want, you can copy this code to a different sprite as well. Means you can change the costume, but first try to make this work. Is this working for everyone? Is this working for everyone? Working? Everyone, I want your selfies on this basically. I would be checking your status. Okay, I want you should keep this status today what we have learned. Okay? Is everyone able to get the desired output? Yes or no?
Yes
or no? Everyone, have you understood the concept? Yes or no? Okay, that's great. So I can ask any question from everyone? Oh, that's good. That's good. Okay. So I think it's 3:15. Students, please keep a photo or a save file of these, okay? Because these are like your hard work, okay? Don't get it into it. To keep a photo of you with it, you can keep a file saved in this PC. So, but keep some not memory, I should say, but some you can keep it like understanding for you for future.